Please feel free to ask questions or engage these gentlemen in dialogue. And then eventually we'll go over to the landing or we'll have lunch. So I know you've seen all this before, but I just wanted to make sure that it can get a little confusing. We need to be able to plug in very quickly and probably bypass a lot of the, you know, American NATO build-up things, so that we can use your
deterrence in the level sector to the Russians, even though the Russians also tried to interfere in part of the exercise and are still doing, I would say, on our GPS systems in the northern parts of Norway. And I have never been to this base before, and it's my first visit here, as you probably also know. And just to have the opportunity to spend a day and a half at the base is really important. And it's also say that I've been also often asked about sort of how is now the sort of bilateral relations between Norway and the United States, since for the last sort of after the election of President Trump. And I'm always saying that there is a continuation from Bush to Obama to Trump, So there is nothing sort of radical new in our bilateral relationship, and it works smoothly, and we are strengthening the bilateral relations day by day, and we are doing that. And I would say that is sort of the key component of the bilateral ties between Norway and
United States. Was just amazed at when he began to work with Brigade North and the Home Guard, you know, and was talking to this liaison, what he was able to glean from the local population, like all those things in Afghanistan that we were trying to do forever and ever, he was able to do in a second. And so that's where I think that's our past is almost a barrier to our future with our cooperation, and that we need to, how can we use the local infrastructure more? And fuel is one, and communication. We're in, it's as good of a facility to start with as I've seen. Wouldn't you concur with that as far as things we've fallen in on before?
Yes, sir. Absolutely.
Capabilities. We'll show you the aircraft, but we can do around 150 knots max airspeed. Flight time for around 4 hours based on the fuel we're taking. And then with a combat range, about 480 nautical miles. So here in the United States, you don't have to go very far, even from North Carolina, to run into some real cold weather challenges, and we sure did. Right out of the gate, we went to West Virginia, ran into snow, ran into cold, and it really it shows us our vulnerability. When you operate in this cold weather, in real cold environments, and you have to the way you do it, and then you talk to Norwegians, they'll tell you warm them. You got to warm the airplanes. You got to put them in a hangar. And so we learned a lot of real valuable things trying to go to Wisconsin, getting up to Wisconsin, and coming back. Flying in Norway was incredible. It was an incredible experience for us, both just operating in that kind of environment and then seeing that terrain.
Yeah.
control of those fires if needed by the ground forces. Deep air support, fires that enable shaping of the battlefield either in time or space in support of that still the ground forces ultimate scheme maneuver. Escort, whether that's escorting an assault package into a zone or and unguided rockets and then a 20 millimeter gun. With the Zulu specifically, we're going through the conversion process right now. It has a greater payload, a little bit longer legs. You're getting 2.2 to 2.5 hours out of it and at a range of about 200 to 250 miles. But yes, we can land in the snow. It's going to be a very gentle easing of the power out in order to ensure that the aircraft is stable on the ground.
Good seeing you. Yeah, it's like
good morning, gentlemen. Major Vallis, Squadron WTI, as well as the Assistant Operations Officer for BMM-365. This will be a brief B-22 capabilities presentation, as well as BMM-365, or BMM as a whole in the Marine Corps. It's medium lift assault support. Primary task is supporting the MAGTF commander. We do that by providing assault support to combat troops, supplies, equipment, day and night, under all weather conditions, during expeditionary joint and combined operations. This list at the bottom is our mission essential task list. As you see, a wide variety of capabilities of the B-22 supporting the MAGTF commander.